A very good morning, class. Today I am here to discuss about the classification and the characteristics of wants. In the last class, we talked about wants. What is a want and why it is so important that every one of us must create some wants. Whatever is sold in the market, whatever is demanded in the market, it's all due to the wants only. We know that wants keep on increasing, keep on cropping every now and then. And another feature of want is the moment one want is satisfied, another want crops up, another want comes up. So wants are unlimited, but means to satisfy those wants are limited. That is what we are going to study about wants today. That what are the characteristics of wants first? The first characteristics are is wants are unlimited, means there is no limitation of wants. From your childhood to now, you have been making many a wants, many a thing, you have been demanding many things, which when fulfilled up, the moment those demands have been fulfilled up, another want or another demand comes up. That is why it is said unlimited, it does not have any limitation, it keeps on increasing every now and then. Okay, no matter on which scale of wanting you are, up to what level you earn, your wants keep on increasing every now and then. Second is, each particular want can be satisfied. This is a myth only that a want can be satisfied. No wants can be satisfied. It can only be satisfied for a temporary point of time. Means for a particular phase of time, it can be satisfied. Like for example, if you have a desire of owning a bicycle, the moment you own a bicycle, your wants are fulfilled, your desires are fulfilled. But as you grow up, as the time passes by, you will have a better demand, you will have a bigger demand, you will have a bigger want. The moment that want takes the place, the want which was satisfied will remain unsatisfied now. That means, again coming to the same point, the first point, that wants are unlimited. There is no limitation to it. We call it that wants can be satisfied. No, wants can never be satisfied. It can only be satisfied for a temporary point of time or for a temporary phase. Third, you say that each particular want can be satisfied. I'll just read out this line since it's a bit of confusing time. Each particular want can be satisfied after certain amount of consumption of that commodity. Suppose you are hungry. After consuming necessary food, your want for food will be satisfied. However, wants are recurring, means they keep on increasing, they keep on fluctuating. The moment your hunger gets satisfied, after some time, after a point of time, after a day, you will feel again hungry and your want will crop up. Once our want for food is satisfied, it is not satisfied forever. After some time, the want for the food will occur again. That is what it says. It may be satisfied, but for a very small point of time, for a very little time. Once you are hungry again, want is desired, want is derived again. Third is, wants are competitive. Wants are competitive means the moment we have a desire, we have a want to satisfy something, we look after the means which can help us to fulfill our needs. That is why wants are called competitive. Means there are unlimited wants, but there are limited means to satisfy. Since human wants are unlimited and means to satisfy them are limited, all wants cannot be satisfied. See, every want which we desire cannot be satisfied. Like for example, if I desire to own an Audi car, it cannot be satisfied right now. I must have a income capacity, I must have the purchasing power. The moment I have the purchasing power, then only I can satisfy my want. If it is not there, that want cannot be satisfied. Now, wants are competitive here means that we will have to look for the alternatives which can create a second line of option for us. If it is not done, we'll have to look for that alternative. If it is about traveling, if it is about owning a car, if it is about modes of transportation, I'll have to look for the other options which can satisfy me for a particular point of time. Therefore, some of the wants will remain unsatisfied. It is in this sense even wants are competitive. You will try to satisfy more urgent wants first and less urgent later on. See, you will have to prioritize, you will have to keep the priority, which want you wish to satisfy first and which one the second, third. You will have to put it in an order. There may be many wants, but you will have to chronolize that, which want is the most urgent one, or which one you want to fulfill at the top level. For example, we cannot postpone the want for necessaries of life. Necessaries of life means the basic factor which is required for the required by the human being for the living, like food, health, food, clothes, shelter, education. This cannot be postponed. If there is a want, that has to be fulfilled now. Next is wants are complementary. Sometimes wants come with a close package, with a group one. Like for example, if there is a want for a car, the petrol is associated with it, because a car cannot function without the petrol. Car cannot function without a school, but without a petrol. So car will follow with the petrol. So these two wants are demanded together. That is why they become joint demand or joint wants or complementary wants. Okay, some wants are complementary. And the last is, wants have varying nature. They keep on varying upon the age, upon the time, upon the fashion. Like whatever is in fashion today, whatever is demanded by the consumers today, it may not be demanded tomorrow. Because every now and then the taste and preferences of the consumers change. Their fashion, their understanding of the concept changes. So that variation actually makes them compatible. Makes them a bit different to choose whatever is available. Means they follow up with the changes. So if that change is not made in the goods or in the services, people will not return to the demanding time. They will end up their demand, they will end up their wants if it is not fulfilled in the manner they want, in the manner the consumers want, in the manner the service owners want. Means the services or the goods which is demanded by the consumer changes with time, changes with fashion, changes with nature, changes with humans to human. That is why they are varying in nature. What may be good for the other may not be good for me. What may be good for me may not be very good for the others. So that variation takes place on a regular basis. So class will keep it till here, the characteristics. In the next class we shall talk about the classification of wants. Thank you.